Hey there, this is Matt Williams, Techno Evangelist, and I wanted to do a really quick video to show you how to set up a long-running process on your Mac and how to update that. Maybe you're pulling that from GitHub repo. So I work for a company called Infra, and we've got a solution called Keypair for managing all your SSH keys. And we've got a got it available via Brew, but for local development and for internal development, we still have it on a GitHub repo, and we're pulling from main all the time. I have a version running from main. With Homebrew, we create a launch agent for you that will automatically start run in the background. But I wanted something for when I'm working with main. And here's what I ended up. So the details of, the fact that I'm doing it for Keypair, that doesn't really matter. You could do this for anything you want. So this is just generally how would you do this. So here we are on my Mac, and I can see I'm in my user's root directory, and then I've got library and then launch agents. So let's zoom in there. So Matt, library, launch agents. And in here, I've got the Homebrew service that has been created. But how would you create this yourself? You can either go into VS Code and edit the plist file yourself, which is an XML file, or you can use a couple of different apps that I found useful. Actually, here's two apps. I own both of them, but I use one of them more often. So first off, there's Lingon X version 9, which came out pretty recently. So this is definitely really useful. I tend to actually use LaunchControl. I can't remember why I have both, but I have both, and LaunchControl is the one that I find the most usable. They both do exactly the same thing. But what it produces, again, you don't have to use these. You can just edit the plist file yourself, which is just an XML file. And I have that in my Obsidian notebook. So here's the plist file that I've created. I'm setting keep alive to true because I want it to stay alive all the time and actually run at load as well. So when the machine boots up, it automatically starts up. And then there's a key for program arguments. In this case, I'm just having it run the Keypair executable with the server command line parameter. And one thing that's a little bit special for how I've got it set up is, it will output to standard output and also output errors to standard error. And I have that being redirected to these two files, Keypair errors and keypair.log. So that's my service. And I just run Launchctl, which is the Mac executable that comes with Mac OS. Launchctl start service, and then Keypair server. To go with that, to update the bits on my local machine, I have this little fish function. And the fish function, I can call it from anywhere. And so if I call it from anywhere, I want it to run this function. And then when it's done, spit me back where I was. So I'm setting a variable called current directory and setting that to whatever the current directory actually is. Present working directory, I believe that stands for. And then I'm calling a launchctl stop Keypair server. So that's my Keypair server launch control agent or launch control plist file. And then I'm changing directories into my directory where the project lives, where the repo is. Just to make sure I'm on the right branch, I git checkout main, and then pull the latest stuff. Then I'll go ahead, because it's written in Go, I'll run go install, and then I'll code sign that using my local key. And then after that's all done, launchctl start Keypair server, and that will go back to that launch agent and start that up, and then go back to the current directory. And that's it. That's all you have to do. It just works. It works really well. And so I'll be using Keypair, using this development version of Keypair, all day. And then every now and then just run KPPI and it updates, takes like, I don't know, 3 seconds to run. And I have the latest bits and it's up and running. It's running in the background all the time. So you could use this for anything you want. And I find it really useful, at least in my environment. So that's a quick look at how to set up a, you know, a long running process and update it halfway along. And again, I really like to use the tool LaunchControl for making this file really easy to build. Okay, thanks a lot. Bye.